Testing, this is 4K.
Yellow light, white light. Oh wait, this is white light, okay, fuck.
Ooh, we got the microphone set up. Hello, hello, hello. It's not fucking fun, eh? All right, guys. Back to the end with my second video. Yeah, today I'm going over my high school portfolio that got me into university. And they say if you can't cringe at your own work, you're not learning. So, first of all, the schools that I got into or applied to. I applied to two different countries, Canada and the UK. Didn't apply to the US because if you can find equally as good schools without having to do the SAT, why not? So in Canada, I applied to Waterloo, Carleton. I applied to UFT and I forgot to apply to UBC, which is actually the school that I would want to go to if I did stay in the country. But I missed the deadline because I forgot to apply. And the one in UFT, I applied, but I forgot to send them my portfolio. So I got denied from the UFT. But I did get into Waterloo and Carleton. And in the UK, I applied to AA, Bath, Salford, Sheffield, Manchester, and finally UCL. I got into all the schools except for AA. AA, I got an interview, but they said like you have to fly over to the UK to do the interview. So, oops. So I didn't want to do that. It's a bit of a fat ticket to get, so just kind of ended it there. I want to say that I did go to UCL for architecture summer camp. This was summer 2017, so the year before I applied there. And I learned a lot from that camp, and it actually, like, that's my drive behind going to the UK for school. And so, okay, let's dive right into my portfolio. I have it ready here. Ooh. It's been a while. So first, cover page. It's just got my name, one of my pieces as background. All right, first page, personal page. I decided to put a little picture of myself, get a little more personal, you know? Something I like, color black and blue, not exactly true. Making beats, completely false. Like, I probably spent like that summer making some beats, but I've stopped it. Barbecuing, bruh. And bodybuilding, okay, it's too cringe. Just gonna skip to the next slide. All right, first project. This one's probably my most developed project and the main project that most schools accepted me for. So this is an architectural project. First of all, I chose this model, which described this type of protein called myoglobin, and it's an oxygen-binding protein found in muscle tissues in almost all mammals. So then I went in and researched whales, which had the largest body mass in all mammals, therefore having the most muscle tissues to carry these oxygen binding proteins. That's the connection that I made there. Studied from a whale that was extremely healthy with a lot of muscle mass and studying its bone structures and protein structures, and then carrying that on to this like kind of span of time and how that muscle tissues deteriorate and you slowly lose your ability to carry all those oxygen binding proteins.
The genius process of documenting the process.
This sense of time and decay came up from my drawings, and I decided to follow that along and study more specifically the effects of decay and the process of decay. So this one, it's three thick boys lying on the page. Gruesome imagery, some might call it. But yeah, I looked at this recording of a pig decaying over the course of like 10 days, and I was documenting what it looked like over the period and also trying to create a language of documenting these changes. So the pigs in three stages, three different days. First day, I documented, you know, rottening of the tissues, the skin, and then the maggots started coming out. So I drew the maggots in red. I dashed them out, and then I dashed out the skin rottening in black. Second one, the same methods, black and red, and then added green to document the stomach acids coming out. And then the last one, which when the pig is completely eaten up and all that's left is kind of these dry skins and bones still being processed by the maggots, because, you know, they eat everything. But yeah, this is just this evolution of time, and the dashing lines is kind of the outcome. This is how to document the different decays. Took that in, went into and more architectural realm. So I started looking at maps, the Las Vegas map, because Las Vegas is the city that's going through the most change from a desert into this like huge entertainment district. And I wanted to continue this process of evolution, but then in a dystopian way where the city decays instead of growing. So in the top right with top left, the red drawing shows the initial city and the city as of right now. And then the decayed version of it is in the bottom. And that's with the same things, the black maybe showing the roads, how the roads kind of expand and go into areas where roads aren't supposed to go because there's no more human inhabitation. And the red documenting how the city shrinks, maybe due to population loss. And then the green space starts taking over, whether it be animals, trees, nature in general. And then from that, very, very literally, I transformed the map into somewhat of a building structure. And yeah, that's the initial architecture I had from this. And then I combined it with one of UCL's professor's drawings. So this is Peter Cook's drawing. And then when I saw it, I kind of, the dystopian feature of it kind of connected with what I was doing. So I wanted to interpret it in my own ways. So I did a couple drawings based on his drawing. And then I combined it with, you know, the previous structure I took from the map to make a basic outline of the building. And then I decayed in the same way, which is shown here in different dashed lines, whether that could be moss, the structure falling apart, or just the natural construction materials getting washed away. And I also did a shaded drawing first, and that's just to show the three-dimensional outlook on it. And then the painting, which documents, you know, the colors a lot better. You can see kind of the moss growing everywhere and the shredded steels and the things just, you know, falling apart. So yeah, that's my first project to start my portfolio. You want to put the best things in the front. And this is one I actually did in UCL. So I was under the tutor's influence in a lot of these process, and I learned a lot from it. I have three projects in total. And you don't need that many, I think. It could be a bit of an overkill and just takes a long time to do. But why I did it is because the first one is from UCL. So if I'm going to be applying there, I probably want to have, you know, some of them, some architecture projects that I was able to. So the second one is indigenous culture, and basically very simple. These are much more straightforward than the first one. So I take, you know, the geometry from the dream catchers, and I study the cedar leaf, which appears in a lot of, you know, symbolistic paintings. I combine the cedar leaf with the dream catcher's geometry to create different shapes, which I then smashed into a plan drawing of somewhat of a lost. I can't fucking speak, man. Oops. So I combine it into a plan of this museum that was supposed to address the Aboriginal's lost culture or heritage. I did a couple colored versions, and the different colors indicate the different programs for the spaces. So some of them, you know, the blue ones could be exhibition spaces, the red ones could be bathrooms, blue ones could be lobbies, like that. And then made a model based on it using just white cards, white foam boards. Just get some nice photos of it, you'll be fine. And then in continuation of that, this is my third architecture project. I combined the Dreamcatcher's geometry again with an Aboriginal painter's painting. And I take from the cedar leaf again to create different geometries from it. And literally, I think I saw a video on YouTube that was like how to create interesting geometries. And it was like, three and two rows, and just like three dots each. So what I did is just I dotted out the main points of a cedar leaf drawing, and then I started connecting the lines in different ways to come up with interesting geometries. And that is what I ended up with. Next, I combined it with some of my previous drawings of my interpretation of the cedar leaf, drawing it in different ways with different meanings. And I found this mechanical one, and then I thought that was probably the best fit with this geometric shape. So I combined the two, and the Cedar City, you know, easy money. It's probably a bit more literal, but, you know, it is a project I did on my own, so. Next, these are just personal art pieces, non-architecture related. Just drawings I've done over the years, whether it's, you know, these ones I did in my free time, and there's some school drawings I put in there just to show I could do different medias. So these ones are like abstract drawings. I love Peter Draws, big inspiration for me during this time. So a lot of black and white pieces I was doing. Vertigo and Ville mentality. Left one I did for fun. Right one I did actually for school, I think. For a chapel booklet for school. Don't ask me. All right, next painting. My first painting in this portfolio. Pretty trash. And this is a bit better. A painting, just expressive painting. This was like things that could express the side of being a student at the school that I was, the high school I was in. This was it, some Tylenols, Red Bulls, and this bracelet, which was supposed to, you know, represent balance, right? See how it's broken? Bars. Next, another painting. This one I liked a lot, actually. I enjoyed doing it because I don't normally do too much color stuff. This one was inspired by another artist, which drew in the same abstract way, and I took from that and combined it with one of my personal photographs, and then I painted it. And this one's a little aids to explain. It was pretty basic, the idea. I took inspiration from this painting that used, you know, animals and these neon colors, which was dripped over it. And I thought that was very much what I would enjoy painting. You know, that's why I started. So I was like, how can I apply my own meaning onto this? I wanted to do it about animal cruelty. Everyone knows Sissel the lion, right? You know, so I chose that as my character. The meaning of it is that, you know, animals, they cannot present you with facial expression. I think the only input of emotion is through their eyes. What I did was cover it up with something valuable to humans as a commodity. And this is digital stuff. This is just combining all of, you know, some of my interests or things that describe me into one piece. Some of you probably know this is the Migo album theme, because I was a huge Migos fan back then. Moab Villain, he designs all their album covers, and there's some amazing arts that he does, like the textures that he makes and just aesthetics, colors, the fire is probably the sickest thing. But yeah, just take things from other artists that you like and, you know, make your own.
Bruh.
Some more digital piece. These are social illustrations that, you know, talk about talk about social topics in the world. The first one is about how, you know, we feed off of it. Second one is about Twitter taking away from our physical freedom. And third one is about Snapchat, which talks about how filters can change your vision of yourself and whether that could mean a dystopian future for us. Too late, how we look online, and that's all that matters to us. We stop caring about ourselves, how our physical body's looking. I'm not body shaming anyone, okay? Fuck. And that is the end of my portfolio. Hope you enjoy that. I'm just gonna give a quick word of advice and really emphasize on how important process is in your portfolio. I've done a fair amount of research on YouTube on people's portfolios. I could say a lot of them are missing, you know, the process work. Everyone's got like descriptions talking about it, but no one has the actual drawing or actual photographs showing it. So that is the biggest thing when you're applying to a top tier school. What they're looking for is your ability to think differently and to come up with unique strategies to design your building. For example, you know, my pig building, right? It is a piece of shit. It doesn't do anything. It's unusable. It's literally a pile of decayed construction material. Could you even call it a building? You got to be able to recognize what you're trying to show is the process. And the process was the most interesting part about the pig project. You know, the rotten pigs, thick boys, they're lovely. They make you go, what the fuck? That is the biggest thing, I think, when you're looking to improve your portfolio and be different from other people. If you guys enjoyed the video, found it helpful, leave a like. Let me know what you guys want to see, if there are any specific requests. And yeah, I am a UCL student. I'm a second year student and the program is 3 years. So I'm looking to document my next year with you guys. That's it. Thank you guys. See you guys next time.